Flutter Bloc provides several solutions for this. The first solution is to use the BlocProvider.o method and give the o method a listen true option. Now, if you put the cursor on the o method, you can see that there is an option called bool listen equal false. In other words, the o method does not listen to counter qubit changes by default. If you want it to listen for state changes and reflect them in the UI, you need to give it the listen true option. Let's do a hard restart and test it. Yes, counter changes are now normally reflected in the UI. Let's test one more thing for a moment here. Let's give the listen true option to the obstating method that calls increment. Let's test after hard restart. An error occurred when the increment button was pressed. Let's take a look at what the error is. The error message clearly states the problem and the solution. Here it says, it is unsupported because may pointlessly reveal the widget associated to the event handler when the widget tree doesn't care about the value. In other words, there is no need to reveal the button, but it is trying to listen to the changing value. And as a solution, it is set to give the listen false option. However, since the default option is listen false, you just need to remove the listen true option. Those familiar with the providers will know that options are exactly the opposite. In provider, the default value of listen argument of providers.o function is false. Again, let's get back by removing the listen false option. The second solution is to use the BlocBuilder widget. The BlocBuilder widget reveals the widget whenever its state changes. This is the basic form of BlocBuilder. BlocBuilder is a Flutter widget that requires a qubit or a block and a builder function. There is no need to separately call obstating method because BlocBuilder takes over the task of looking up the widget tree by using the specified qubit or block type, block provider, and current build context. And the builder function reveals the widget in response to the new state. Now, let's apply BlocBuilder to the widget that displays the counter value. You don't need to look up through block provider anymore. Let's wrap the center widget in a BlocBuilder widget. Here, state is an instance of counter state, so we can access the counter value through the state.counter. Let's do a hard restart and test. The counter value is now displayed normally. The third method is to use the build context extension method. We'll see how to do this next time.